medication hasn't hurt me, none. Well, I can read the writing on the wall. Kodachrome, they give us the nice bright colors, they give us the greens of summers, make you think all the world's a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera, I'd love to take your phone.
Understand the power and beauty of your youth until they've faded. But trust me, in 20 years, you'll look back at photos of yourself and recall in a way you can't grasp now how much possibility lay before you and how fabulous you really looked. You are not as fat as you imagine. Don't worry about the future, or worry, but know that worrying as effective as trying to solve an algebra equation by chewing bubblegum. The real troubles in your life are apt to be things that never crossed your worried mind, the kind that blindsides you at 4 p.m. on some idle Tuesday. Do one thing every day that scares you. Sing. Don't be reckless with other people's hearts. Don't put up with people who are reckless with yours. floss. Don't waste your time on jealousy. Sometimes you're ahead, sometimes you're behind. The race is long, and in the end, it's only with yourself. Remember compliments you receive. Forget the insults. If you succeed in doing this, tell me how. Keep your old love letters. Throw away your old bank statements. Stretch. Don't feel guilty if you don't know what you want to do with your life. The most interesting people I know didn't know at 22 what they wanted to do with their lives. Some of the most interesting 40-year-olds I know still don't. Get plenty of calcium. Be kind to your knees. You'll miss them when they're gone. Maybe you'll marry. Maybe you won't. Maybe you'll have children. Maybe you won't. Maybe you'll divorce at 40. Maybe you'll dance the funky chicken on your 75th wedding anniversary.
Friends, ladies and gentlemen, Steve Lockshin. Wow, I was really lucky to get to write my own introduction, so I hope that wasn't too much. I am a bit of an instigator. I learned a couple things while we were hanging out in the green room. Mike has the app that measures how high you can throw your phone up in the air, and he is wearing Axe today. Actually, I like to joke around a lot, but what I want to talk about today is a much more serious topic, and it's not only where our industry's heading, but what I think are the core components of where our industry's heading. And I want to use a personal experience to kind of start things off, because the key of what I think we need to do is connect with our clients. I'm a lucky guy in that for the last almost 50 years, I've had most of my grandparents alive. And last week I lost my last grandparent, my grandmother, who's 97, awesome lady. While we were going through her things, we found a note that I had written her almost 40 years ago. Now, I bring this up for a couple reasons, but let's spend some, this is serious stuff. This is serious stuff. Someone had to help me. So I wrote this note to my grandmother, and I'll get to it in a minute. I do want you to know I'm a tech geek, as Mike said, and so I started an early version of a spreadsheet when I wrote this note. I started on the right, column LL, with all the things Dad had done to me. Spell check was not available in this software. And then, of course, I just cut and paste from the right column to left column because Mom had done the same.
I think I'll take a moment to celebrate my age, the ending of an era and the turning of a page. Now it's time to focus in on where I go from here. Lord, have mercy on my next 30 years. In my next 30 years, I'm gonna have some fun. Try to forget about all the crazy things I've done. Maybe now I've conquered all my adolescent fears, and I'll do it better in my next 30 years. My next 30 years, I'm gonna settle all the scores. Cry a little less, laugh a little more. Find a world of happiness without the hate and fear. Figure out just what I'm doing.